Welcome to this SEI Beat the Heat episode dedicated to preparing at home for hot and humid climates. As an athlete, official, volunteer, or staff member, you'll need to be at your best for the competition. This video will introduce you to the three main techniques you need to master to beat the heat: acclimatisation, hydration, and cooling. For para athletes, these techniques may need to be adapted to your specific condition and based on your doctor's recommendations. Let's start with acclimatisation. Acclimatisation is the action of getting your body used to a different environment and to function normally in that new environment. Full acclimatisation can take from 2 to 4 weeks, which is why we recommend you start the process at least 2 weeks before travel, which will be hugely beneficial for when you arrive on site. How do you acclimatise properly? To acclimatise in the best possible way, you should ideally train every day from 1 to 1.5 hours in similar hot and humid conditions to the competition country. Here are several options how you can do this. Train during the hottest parts of the day and wear impermeable clothing for increased sweating. Train in a professional environmental chamber or create one at home in a room where heaters and humidifiers, or alternatively pots of boiling water, can create the required heat and humidity levels. Go to a location nearby that can provide similar conditions for training. If possible, plan to travel to the event country more than 2 weeks before the competition starts to perform a full acclimatization directly on location. In all cases, always monitor your progress and adapt your strategy accordingly. And remember, even if you live in a hot and dry country, you still need to acclimatize to humidity because it places considerable strain on the body. Hydration. Hydration is vital. Even the smallest degree of dehydration can negatively impact your physical and mental performance as well as your health. As soon as you start your acclimatization process, implement the following. Drink regularly and at all times, especially before, during, and after training sessions. During training, take small and regular intakes of water to avoid risks of dehydration. To replace the electrolytes lost in sweat, such as sodium and potassium, use isotonic drinks. You can create your own drink by combining 200 ml of ordinary fruit squash, 800 ml of water, and a pinch of salt. Monitor your hydration levels. Use a color chart to compare your urine against it. The darker the color, the more dehydrated you are. Increase fluid intake to ensure proper levels at your next check. Weigh yourself frequently. A 1% loss in body weight is an early indication of dehydration. Note that the sensation of dehydration may be reduced by some medical conditions and aging. A good hydration plan and regular checks are therefore essential. Cooling techniques. A high body temperature can lead to severe consequences. You need to learn cooling techniques early so that they become second nature for you prior to competition. There are two phases. Before you exercise, it's all about staying cool for as long as possible. Stay in the shade and warm up in the shade if you can. Use external cooling devices, ice vests, cold towels, and fans. Ingest cold drinks or ice slurries. After you exercise, it's all about cooling down as quickly as possible. Move to an air-conditioned room or shaded area. Rehydrate. Use cold towels and fans if available. Loosen clothing and remove jackets, protective gear, helmet, and dark-colored apparel. Apply cold water on forearms or take a cold shower. Change to a dry outfit if possible. That's it for today. You are now ready to prep yourself for hot and humid environments. Stay safe and stay tuned for our dedicated heat and humidity series so that you can go out and beat that heat.